The old saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure, could easily apply following the devastating fire that toppled a Seminole County landmark in 2012.
The big tree, which had stood in Seminole County for more than 3,000 years, was reduced to charred remains after a massive fire.
WESH 2'S Dave McDaniel shows us there is beauty which lives on.
Back in 2012, the big tree was all but destroyed by fire. You can see there's the base there and some of the charred wood sticking up into the air. But there was a lot of that charred wood that ended up littering the ground. Now that charred wood is being turned into something beautiful.
I'm already proud, but to see them on display will probably be the highlight of my life.
Every artist starts with a blank canvas. But when the blank canvas is burned wood from a Central Florida landmark, every piece of art takes on additional importance. Only so much wood was left once the senator, the historic bald cypress tree, was leveled by someone accused of being careless with fire.
To be able to work with and hold on to and help to be part of the legacy of the senator, I mean, the senator gets to live on.
This was the original county tourist attraction. You know, we've heard stories of people coming in on paddle wheel boats in the St. John's, getting off and riding horse and buggies to see the senator.
The plan hatched after the fire allowed selected artists to gather wood and use half to create art and donate the art back to the county. The rest of the wood collected could be crafted and sold.
To see something so beautiful come out of that, it does give you some sense of closure or a feeling that, you know, something beautiful came out of something so tragic.
At some point, these pieces will be on public display. A couple decades ago, some very smart people knew that the senator was significant, and they wanted to make sure it was preserved. So they took some genetic material, developed some clones, and that's one of them, one of 10 which survived. It's now planted in Big Tree Park, and some school kids appropriately called it the Phoenix. Reporting in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.